This is NBC.
West River, South Dakota residents clean up after tornadoes, while East River gets hit tonight.
Secretary of State James Baker is in Syria, working for peace in the Middle East. But is it a losing battle? Good evening, I'm Carson Walker.
And I'm Denise Anderson. Severe weather continues across some parts of South Dakota tonight, but the forecast says we'll dry out and warm up.
In sports, David Kale says the Twins stay hot, and the local softball team eyes a national championship. Stay with us. KDLT News is next.
It's the Coors Light Rock and Roll Summer. Yes, the beer that won't fill you up will be dancing its can off all summer long. Just visit the display and look for the specially marked cans, and you could instantly win the ultimate stereo system, Denon portable CD players, cassettes from Capitol Records, and thousands of other great music prizes. We know it's only Coors Light Rock and Roll Summer, but we like it.
I want a car that's economical, affordable, and fun to drive. Buick Skylark.
I want a car with style, luxury, a quiet ride, and one that's dependable. Buick. Park Avenue.
Get the best of both worlds and world-class quality with Buick. Buy now and take advantage of dealer incentives, factory cash rebates, and special spring allocations. You'll save like never before.
From the sporty
to the luxurious, Buick is the best of both worlds.
Only at your quality Buick dealers.
Looking for a way to get more pounds of gain from your pasture? GTA Feeds Calf Creep and Range Grow is the answer. These GTA Creep feeds, now with 14% protein, will get your calves off to a faster, healthier, more efficient start. Both Calf Creep and Range Grow are available with Bovatec to give calves that extra push to reach their full potential. You can find these fine GTA products at Corson Cooperative Company, Farmers Co-op Company Brookings, Farmers Co-op Elevator Beersford, and Watertown Co-op Elevator.
You're watching KDLT. This is KDLT News, complete news from around the area, with Carson Walker and Denise Anderson. The exclusive AccuWeather forecast with Paige Gores, and the latest sports with David Kale.
Good evening. Thank you for joining us. Severe weather made its way through parts of South Dakota tonight, and it looks like the worst of the storm is past.
We hope so anyway. This is what the storm looked like to the west as it entered the county about 8:30. When the storm hit at Houston Speedway, people scattered, literally, but the severe thunderstorm warning for eastern Minnehaha County has expired now, and it will not be renewed. At 9:15, a line of thunderstorms stretched from 25 miles north of Brookings to 60 miles south of Sioux Falls near Vermilion. Now, these thunderstorms were moving east at 25 miles an hour and will be moving into southwest Minnesota. Stay tuned. We'll have more in our weather show a little bit later on.
Now in the Black Hills, residents spent today literally picking up the pieces after tornadoes swept through that area last night. Fire officials say miraculously no one was killed and only a few people suffered minor injuries. At least three tornadoes touched down in the Rapid City area yesterday. Several trailer homes were destroyed or damaged. Many were lifted up and twisted apart, some landing hundreds of feet away.
Keep, you know, Matthew's stuff and clothes. What do you do with clothes?
Why not just sort? Well, we can sort and, you know, anything that's salvageable that looks like it's halfway good.
Yeah.
In Edgemont, officials say at least seven funnel clouds passed through the area, damaging buildings and taking the roofs off of homes. In Piedmont, the Red Cross and Meade County Disaster Services are coordinating the cleanup work. Meanwhile, in Crawford, Nebraska, residents are also cleaning up after a severe storm Friday night caused flooding. This afternoon, rescue teams located the body of a man swept away in a flash flood. Hundreds of cattle were also caught in the current as the White River rose 8 to 10 feet above normal. Many homes were damaged, and the city water system is still out as of tonight. Two Red Cross workers from Sioux Falls are in Crawford tonight helping with the relief efforts.
A group of people in Sioux Falls used Mother's Day to draw attention to the unborn children killed by abortion. Members of the Dakota Pro-Life Action League picketed the Women's Medical Service Clinic in Sioux Falls this afternoon. They say they want to remind people that the abortion issue is still important and needs to be remembered, especially on a day that celebrates motherhood. One of the Dakota Pro-Life Action League members says people should get as mad about abortion as they have about the murder of 11-year-old Katie Clary this week in Sioux Falls. The movie on KDLT earlier tonight, In the Line of Duty, Manhunt in the Dakotas, has a local angle. U.S. Marshal Gene Abdallah of Sioux Falls was involved in the 1983 investigation of the killing of two federal marshals. The movie portrays North Dakota farmer Gordon Call, who refused to pay his taxes and became violent over the issue. In a showdown with police, Call and his friends killed two federal marshals. Call got away with it, and the chase became one of the most intensive manhunts in FBI history. Right after the shooting, Abdallah sent two marshals from South Dakota to take charge in North Dakota until the FBI set up a task force. He says much of the investigation took place in northern South Dakota. Abdallah says the law enforcement officials in the shootout were in a no-win situation. They were trying to serve just a misdemeanor warrant to Call when the showdown began, so they couldn't fire until Call started shooting. Well, still ahead on KDLT News, the Secretary of State continues to work towards peace in the Middle East.
And another vestige of the Cold War is blown apart. Stay with us.
With the caution flag, the Memorial 300 continues.
At Pastrano General Motors in Madison and Huron, our countdown to sell 300 cars before the end of May is going well.
But with 220 to go, we need your help. We'll do anything possible to meet our goal of 300 sold.
Own a brand new Geo Metro or Chevy S10. Your choice, $179 down and $179 a month.
Your choice, $179 down and $179 a month. We need your business and we're willing to pay for it.
So come see us before the month ends at Pastrano General Motors in Madison and Huron.
When Dave Thomas, the founder of Wendy's, suddenly has a craving for his big new bacon mushroom melt, he'll drive any distance and face any obstacle to get one. Because it's a quarter pound of fresh beef, three strips of bacon and mushrooms in a cheddar cheese sauce, all on a toasted Kaiser bun. Wendy's new bacon mushroom melt.
When you gotta have one, you gotta have one.
Come in and try our bacon mushroom melt today, only at Wendy's.
For 13 years, he's waited to die in California's gas chamber, and the father of one of his victims has booked a front row seat.
I think he should die the same way that he killed his victims.
The stars come out for Madonna's new movie, but do they dare to tell the truth?
Does she shock me? Absolutely.
A Current Affair Extra, tonight at 10:30, following KDLT News.
And I've got a mouthful of a vegetarian dish because you've asked for it. You say, please cook vegetarian. Now, so I've taken some beans and lentils and some goat cheese and fresh herbs and a little wine. Oh, you can't miss this one. It's just for you. Okay?
Tomorrow morning at 11.
Secretary of State James Baker was in Syria today. He spoke with President Hafez al-Assad about a possible Middle East peace conference to settle the Arab-Israeli conflict.
In Damascus, Mr. Baker was wooing President Assad with Saudi Arabia and the Gulf states' decision to send an observer to any peace conference. Mr. Baker has been buoyed by what he's termed a breaking of age-old taboos. Never before would such Arab states have considered coming anywhere near the Israelis. In Jerusalem, at this morning's cabinet meeting, a different view. Although Foreign Minister David Levy privately described the Saudi move as progress, the man at the top, Prime Minister Itzhak Shamir, believes it's irrelevant.
We would like the Gulf states to participate in the peace process, but in a status of observers, there is no tangible contribution to the peace process because they maintain a state of war with us and a boycott and all the rest. And if they were to change all of this, put an end to the state of war, then they can participate even as observers.
In Bethlehem this afternoon, the continuing West Bank violence, which only a peace conference with adequate Palestinian representation at it can solve. And highlighting the problem of continued Jewish settlements in the occupied territories, which the Americans have condemned, a bullet-ridden Palestinian car attacked this afternoon by armed settlers, wounding two boys aged 4.5 and 5. The settlers claimed the driver of the car had tried to force their vehicle off the road.
More violence broke out in South Africa today when a large group of heavily armed Zulus rampaged through a black squatter camp. The BBC's James Robbins reports on the violence that killed at least 22 people.
After weeks of slaughter in the townships, the worst single attack so far. This shack settlement for some of South Africa's millions of homeless systematically laid waste. Everywhere there are bodies in Swaneville, victims hacked or burned to death. Survivors say up to 1,000 Zulus from men's hostels in the nearby township of Kahiso attacked an hour and a half before dawn. Everyone was asleep. There was little chance of escape. Those who did manage to hide or to flee say the attackers were supporters of Chief Buthelezi's Inkatha organization and were escorted here by police in armored vehicles, vehicles known as hippos.
Some of the Zulus were coming out of those hippos.
There is no independent evidence, but allegations against the security forces are now so frequent that the ANC is convinced there are rogue elements running out of control of President de Klerk's leadership. Wreckers determined to preserve white rule by poisoning any prospect for negotiated change. Certainly, this attack succeeded in unsettling the whole of Kahiso, a township not so far drawn into the worst of the conflict. This afternoon, ANC supporters were gathering in the streets, possibly planning a revenge attack. Police trying to drive them off the road, then using tear gas to reimpose a sort of order amid the growing anger. James Robbins, BBC News, Johannesburg.
The Soviet Union destroyed the last of its intermediate-range ballistic missiles today. U.S. officials witnessed the event. The destruction of the SS-20s was carried out under the INF Treaty signed with the Soviet Union and the United States in 1987. One U.S. observer says it signifies a change for the better. He hopes to ban underground nuclear weapons testing next. On May 1st, the U.S. destroyed its last cruise missile at David Monathan Air Base in Arizona. News continues. We'll have the status on the storm moving across South Dakota tonight.
Well, after some bad weather, tomorrow's going to look like summer. Stay with us.
Plymouth believes that your life is worth something, even if your bank account isn't. So we put a driver's airbag in the least expensive car we make. The Plymouth Sundance America, the lowest priced car in the world with an airbag. If you're blessed with more brains than money, buy a Sundance America and protect them both.
First-time new car buyers get an additional $500 cash back on a new Sundance in stock at your neighborhood Chrysler Plymouth dealer.
Hometown, a historical look at Crooks. It's rumored that Jesse James stopped at a barn just outside of Crooks to count his loot and get a night's sleep after a bank robbery in Minnesota. Many original buildings remain in Crooks, including the Benton Township Hall, built in 1919, and Crooks General Store that now houses Roskin's Dakota Pizza. The Crooks Volunteer Fire Department has been an active part of the community since 1925. Hometown, brought to you by Stanford Fire and Casualty Agency. As an independent agent, they will be happy to tailor your insurance program to your individual needs.
When one car maker wins more major awards in 2 years than most car makers could hope for in a lifetime, there's a word for that. Mitsubishi. The Mirage GS, picked as most reliable in its class. Mitsubishi Montero, car and driver's best buy in sport utility trucks under $20,000. The 3000 GTV R4, Motor Trend's import car of the year. Or the Eclipse, placed on car and driver's 10 best list and priced as low as $11,990. The new Mitsubishis are available here at Terry Schulte Mitsubishi.
This is your most powerful weapon against crime. It's your link to Crime Stoppers. All calls are anonymous, and tips that lead to indictments receive cash rewards. On the night of April 19th, 15 vehicles on the Ted Tufte Dodge car lot were damaged by three or more persons running across the hoods of the cars. The cars were parked on the north side lot. Damage total is more than $5,000. If you have information about this or other crimes, call Crime Stoppers, 339-7007.
Oh, what a night, huh? And what a day. Heated up awful quick in the Sioux Empire, and it looks like those temperatures are going to stick around through a good part of the week. It's going to actually feel like summer. Last week, you can forget about it. We aren't going to see temperatures that low for a little while. Sioux Falls today reached a high of about 86, 87 for Mitchell, as well as Aberdeen, and 80s for the rest of the state were the highs. So it looked like it got up there pretty high, and it's going to stay pretty warm. Temperatures around the state at this hour, Rapid City is the cool spot with 57. They're kind of behind the front that's been causing all the damage and the heavy thunderstorms that's been pushing its way through the state. 70 up in Brookings, and otherwise 60s and 70s for pretty much the state tonight. Taking a look at our tornado watch for tonight, which is still in effect, just so you know this, until 1 o'clock a.m. tonight. We've got a tornado watch for this area. Now, a tornado watch, in case you've forgotten, means that conditions are favorable for tornadoes and severe thunderstorms in and close to the watch area. So persons in these areas should be on the lookout for those things. Our temperature right now in Sioux Falls is 69 degrees, and in the sky, thunder showers are still happening around the area. We received a lot of hail tonight in some areas. We'll tell you about that in a second. Winds are out of the northwest at 17, gusting to 44. Those are some strong gusts. Barometer is holding steady, and the humidity is at 71%. Taking a look at our satellite map for tonight, we can see where that cloud, right where that frontal system is going, you can see where the clouds go right north and south there. They go up and down there. You can see right where that path is moving, and it's just moving its way out of South Dakota, going to be hitting into Minnesota later on tonight. Actually, it's probably hitting there about now. But the thunderstorms, a front causing heavy thunderstorms in parts of our area this evening, will push through, and there's the air behind that is not cool, but it's drier. And so we're going to see things lighten up a little bit, and it's going to be clearing off, and it's going to be sunny skies for tomorrow. Taking a look at our national radar, we can see the extent of it. We had some hail reported in Howard, South Dakota tonight. That was golf ball size hail that was reported. Marble size hail at Canastota, dime size hail between Salem and Canastota. A few tornadoes were reported, funnel clouds that they say touched down near Mitchell. So we haven't heard any reports on damage on that yet, but we will keep you posted and we'll see what we can find out there. Tonight, our lows are going to be in the 50s. It's still going to be pretty warm out, and for the 40s for the western part of the state. Taking a look at our highs for tomorrow, it's going to be in the 80s. Another warm day, but we aren't going to see the severe weather. Taking a look at tomorrow's map, we can see just where that system is going. We're going to have a big high pressure system centered right over our state, and that's going to bring clear skies and warmer temperatures. Taking a look at our forecast for tonight in the Sioux Empire, we're going to have windy and warm conditions, and we are going to see some thunderstorms in parts of the area, so be on the lookout for those. It still could be pretty nasty out there. But otherwise, it's going to be cooler and clear later on tonight, low of about 55. Tomorrow, we're going to see less humid conditions, sunshine very warm, high of 86 degrees and winds out of the west. And for tomorrow night, mainly clear with a low of about 53, winds out of the southwest at 5 to 12. And our extended forecast looks like we're going to see highs in the 80s on Tuesday, near 90 again. So it's going to be a couple warm days in a row there. Wednesday, high of 80. Thursday, about 76. So partly sunny skies.
Real nice.
Those days. Yeah.
Drying out weather.
I'm ready for it to calm down, as you can see.
Get the corn in the
You're
field.
A mess.
But Houston's got a little rained out today, but
Well, we're going to talk a little softball. A lot of fun to see a team doing as well as Augustana is doing, and we'll cover them next week from the national tournament. Talk about that, the rest of the sports, coming up next.
These are some of the sounds you'll hear outside the new Buick Park Avenue. This is the sound inside. The Buick Park Avenue is one of the quietest, most dependable vehicles on the road today. Consumer Digest chose Park Avenue as the best car buy of the year. Plus, with every new 1991 Buick, you get 24-hour emergency roadside assistance. Come and discover the sounds of Buick quality at your nearest quality Buick dealer.
Hi, I'm Sylvia.
And I'm Murph. You're invited to join us and our sponsors to the Sioux Empire Senior Options Expo to be held in Sioux Falls, May 20 and 21.
Senior Options offer people like us 2 days of events to help us stay active, healthy, and independent.
And don't miss Art Linkletter and Tony Randall.
And the Senior Prom.
Join us for Senior Options.
The Golden Girls, 5 nights a week at 6:30, only on KDLT.
Wesley, what have you done?
The two guys just brought it.
Perhaps they were the pinball fairies.
On the next Mr. Belvedere.
Mr. Belvedere.
Mr. Belvedere is a pinball jerk.
Mr. Belvedere is going to become king of the fire gods.
The butler's gone bonkers, and the kids go full tilt to save him.
You're not going to fire Mr. Belvedere, are you?
It is a thought.
It's totally flipped out comedy on the next Mr. Belvedere.
Mr. Belvedere, tomorrow at 4, only on KDLT.
They're on their way. The Augustana softball team has earned a bid to the National Division II Final Four tournament next weekend in Midland, Michigan. The Vikings would have to beat a tough St. Cloud State club today to do that. A beautiful day for a ball game at Augustana. Plenty of fans out there today. Fifth inning, no score. Viking pitcher Julie Krauth helping her own cause as she lashes a single to left. K.K. Orstad comes in and Augie leads it 1-0. Vikings defense superb today. Example, fifth inning, grounder bounces off Ferris Grund, but Angie Hopkins barehands it and throws to Grund to get Lisa Carlisle. Then one out, one on. Pam Carvey to Janelle Teakin in right, and she nails the runner at first, doubling her off. Beautiful play to the sixth, still 1-0. Ferris Grund flies to right. Jeannie DeBase would fire for home, but Kim Sudbeck beats the throw to the plate. Augustana leads 2-0. The final out, as Augie does no softball of the game. Jerry Jensen lining out to shortstop Kim Corey. Corey doubles off DeBase, and Augustana going for a national title next weekend in Midland, Michigan.
You know, I think we've just made a pact out here that now that we're going on, let's go for the top.
I mean, you can't even describe the feeling that goes, you know, through you. I mean, it's like excitement, and yet you're nervous because it's the Final Four. And, I mean, what's going through your mind now is national championship, you know. It may seem out of reach, but, you know, that's the next goal now.
Pairings just in from the NCAA. Augustana ranked seeded second in that tournament. They will play Bloomsburg of Pennsylvania Friday evening in Midland, Michigan. The number one seed is Portland State. Well, the Twins are only 3 games out of first place in the American League West. The Yankees beat Oakland today. The Tigers visited the Dome. To Minneapolis we'll go. A good game for the Twins. Bottom of the first, no score. Kirby Puckett whaps it into right field. Shane Mack comes around to score. Chuck Knobloch motoring for third, and Tiger third baseman Travis Fryman ends up on top of Knobloch. Come on, Chuck. Let him go. Still first inning. Chili Davis, pow, a 3-run blast into the upper deck at the Metrodome. 4-0, Twins. Scott Erickson, 7 shutout innings, 3 hits allowed. He sits down Cecil Fielder here. To the bottom of the third will go Chili Davis again. 7th home run of the year, 2nd of the day. Minnesota rolling, wins it 8-3. California, a loser today at Cleveland. Tom Candiotti, a good outing there. Kansas City at Milwaukee. 3rd inning, Gary Thurman singles to left. Sean Berry would come in to score, but Greg Vaughn comes up throwing to the plate. He'll nail Terry Shumpert. Not even that close a play. Nice toss. 9th inning, 4-3 Kansas City. Danny Tartable bounces one into left field, and Brian McCray waltzes in. It's 5-3 Royals, and Kansas City finally wins a game. The final, 6-4. Texas routed Boston today. It was again New York over Oakland, 10-6. Toronto beating the White Sox, and Seattle beating Baltimore. Atlanta at Pittsburgh, divisional leaders. First inning, Ron Gant with a man on. See ya. Gant taking Vincent Palacios deep to left. It's 2-0 Braves. We'll go to the 7th inning. Dave Justice, the hitter, casual stance, pow! Nothing casual about that. Justice, a 2-run shot to right, 4-1 Braves, and Atlanta on top of the NL West goes on to win it 6-1. Cincinnati took care of Chicago second day in a row. Hal Morris really hitting the ball. Philadelphia, 7-3 over Los Angeles. It's Montreal beating San Diego by a couple. New York took 11 innings to beat San Francisco, and St. Louis looks to beat Houston. Well, some thought the series between the Bulls and the Sixers would be tight and down to the wire. Chicago quickly changing that chance. The Bulls playing today at the Spectrum in Philadelphia. Second quarter, Bulls in red. Michael Jordan. Need I say more? The Bulls lead at 48-33. Third quarter, Charles Barkley grabs the loose ball. Look at the one bounce pass to Hershey Hawkins, who doesn't blow the layup. Barkley trying to fire the Sixers up. Then it would be B.J. Armstrong on the break. Barkley hits him like a freight train. Watch it again. Ouch. Charles and company didn't have it today, though, as Chicago wins it 101-85. Warrior fans in Oakland telling Jack Nicholson today, we're going to beat your Lakers, as Nicholson looks on. He's not impressed. The Lakers were impressed by Tim Hardaway leaping for the steal. He'll take it in for 2. This is early on, 13-11, Lakers led. Magic Johnson isolated on Chris Mullin, and he takes it right side, beats the help. The bucket and foul, Lakers by 10, and they wouldn't look back. Sam Perkins scored 27 points today. He drops the nice left hook shot here, and Los Angeles winning a big one at Golden State, 123-107, the final. Portland at Utah, third quarter action. Terry Porter, the steal from John Stockton. to Clyde Drexler and to Cliff Robinson. Hello. Blazers lead at 82-68 heading to the fourth. Jazz comes back. Stockton inside to Karl Malone. He muscles in for two, and Utah took the lead, but Clyde Drexler would hit this jumper with time running out, and Portland holds off the Jazz to win it. 104-101 as you look at the scoreboard. Portland leads that series 3-1 back to Portland. L.A. leading that series 3-1 going back to L.A., and Chicago also leading that series 3-1, and they'll go back to Chicago. It looks like those series are more or less over. We will have more on the Augustana softball team tomorrow at 6. Five players named to the all-tournament team.
Oh, that's great.
Good. Congratulations to them. That's great. I think the Minnehaha County Commission is forming environmental policy, and Raven Industries receives a prestigious award. Ben Boyette has more on these developments in this week's Forward Report.
Forward Report, a look at the changing economic picture in the Sioux Empire. This week, the Minnehaha County Commission and planners heard from the public on ideas to improve on a proposal to cut the amount of solid waste generated in the county. A draft ordinance covers 18 single-spaced pages, and if passed, it would become the fourth cornerstone in the county's environmental laws to clean up water, land, and disposal sites. Also this week, the South Dakota Department of Tourism conducted seminars to let even small attractions know how important they are to promoting tourism in the state. The seminars, aimed at furthering hospitality, went on in many communities, including Sioux Falls, Yankton, Mitchell, Brookings, Huron, and Watertown. And the Small Business Administration honored South Dakota's own Raven Industries this week with the coveted Entrepreneurial Success of the Year Award. Raven beat out companies from a six-state region to win the award. For the Forward Report, I'm Ben Boyette.
With the caution flag, the Memorial 300 continues.
At Pastrano General Motors in Madison and Huron, our countdown to sell 300 cars before the end of May is going well.
But with 220 to go, we need your help. We'll do anything possible to meet our goal of 300 sold.
Own a brand new Geo Metro or Chevy S10. Your choice, $179 down and $179 a month.
Your choice, $179 down and $179 a month. We need your business and we're willing to pay for it.
So come see us before the month ends at Pastrano General Motors in Madison and Huron.
Prom and graduation are just the beginning. Celebrate with style. Leave alcohol out. Best wishes to all graduates from Toshiba America Information Systems.
Well, some mothers celebrated their day today by taking a ride on an elephant. Mothers, fathers, and children could take a ride on an elephant for $2 today at the Great Plains Zoo. The elephant rides were brought to the zoo by an organization called Craig's Elephants. The group travels throughout the country performing in circus acts, promotional activities, and at zoos. The elephants have received a lot of attention while at the Great Plains Zoo. The elephants gave rides yesterday and today only.
And a unique way of celebrating Mother's Day.
Oh, you bet. They were great. I wanted to get on one of those.
An elephant, huh?
That was fun.
All right. Well, we've got a lot of weather going on here. We've had what?
It's in here somewhere, really. Tonight still we've got a tornado watch that's in effect until 1 a.m. tonight for parts of extreme east central South Dakota. You can see it there in the red area, and it's going to be, it's going to be in effect, like I said, until 1 o'clock. So be on the lookout for that. You could see some thunderstorms developing out of that and possibly some other things. So taking a look at our forecast then for tonight, still we're going to see windy and warm conditions with thunderstorms in parts of the area. Like I said, especially in those tornado watch areas, be on the lookout. Otherwise, that front system that's going to be pushing its way through is going to bring cooler and clear skies later on tonight with a low about 55. Tomorrow, less humid. Yay. Sunshine and very warm. High of about 86 degrees and winds out of the west. So things will be calming down tomorrow. Tomorrow night, mainly clear, low of about 53.
Okay. So what are some of the things? And we had a couple of tornadoes spotted. I know somebody thought they saw one out here outside of the station, too.
Yeah.
We had a lot of some hail.
Yeah. There was some hail in Sioux Falls. There was a brief tornado in touchdown near Platte. There was a tornado spotted on the ground near Mitchell, northeast of Mitchell, I should say, a tornado touchdown in Fulton. And a lot of hail reported at the airport here in Sioux Falls. Wind gusts reported up to 48 miles per hour, so you need to bolt things down, I think, tonight, because we could still see some of that. You never know with the tornado watch out.
But no reports of damage from any of this?
No, not yet. No injuries, so we'll keep our fingers crossed. Hopefully it'll stay that way.
David, coming up in sports tomorrow, this week?
Well, we just keep an eye on Augustana, Bloomsburg of Pennsylvania. They played them when they were in Florida earlier this year and split with them, if I'm remembering right. Anyway, they're ranked second in that NC2A Final Four tournament. It's going to be fun. Starts Friday in Michigan.
All right.
Good
enough. Thank you, David. And thank you, folks, for joining us this evening. We'll see you again next weekend.
Have a good week.
McDonald's explodes another myth.
If it's low fat, it can be delicious.
Not so. Introducing McLean Deluxe, made with a 91% fat-free beef patty.
Low fat and delicious? Can't be done.
Can too. You wanted great burger taste with a lot less fat. Only McDonald's responded. New McLean Deluxe will blow you away.
It's terrific. It can't be low fat.
It's both. New McLean Deluxe. After billions and billions, another first at McDonald's today.
I want a car that's economical, affordable, and fun to drive. Buick Skylark.
I want a car with style, luxury, a quiet ride, and one that's dependable. Buick. Park Avenue.
Get the best of both worlds and world-class quality with Buick. Buy now and take advantage of dealer incentives, factory cash rebates, and special spring allocations. You'll save like never before.
From the sporty
to the luxurious, Buick is the best of both worlds.
Only at your quality Buick dealers.
Threshold Youth Services invites you to make a strike for youth at the second annual Bowl for Our Kids Bowl-a-thon on Sunday, May 19th at Sport Bowl and Suburban Lanes in Sioux Falls. Get a team together in your spare time and raise some money for Threshold programs and projects. For more information, call Threshold Youth Services at 334-1414. Hurry, it starts rolling on Sunday, May 19th at 1 p.m.
KDLT, broadcasting in true stereo.